So in terms of the sequencing question, I think that the paradigm currently is that patients will receive at this point, pembrolizumab as part of their frontline therapy if they have PD-L1 expression at least 50%. Patients will receive chemotherapy as part of their frontline therapy if they don't have that degree of PD-L1 expression, and whether or not the other should be used is an area of controversy. So clearly, whether or not you should combine all of these agents in the frontline setting, I think is an area that I hope to see data from in frontline studies. And I know there are phase 3 studies, many that are ongoing. One other question that I think is really important that unfortunately I think we have not seen enough data on are whether there are patient populations where you really could reserve a PD-1 or PD-L1 inhibitor for at least third or more salvage type therapies. There certainly are patients who will do better, for instance, on second line regimens, docetaxel ramucirumab, other single agent chemotherapy approaches, than if they were to receive a PD-1 inhibitor. The question is, can you have definable populations for whom that is the case? And I would argue that to date, we don't really have that, but if one starts looking through and combing through the data that is generated from all of these tremendous number of studies that we are conducting, I think it is likely that we will be able to find groups of patients for whom this is not really going to be a very appealing option and should be reserved really for a true salvage situation.